Prime creator tells his her point of view. May 6, 2013. My dear children, this is Prime creator. It is your first chance, now, to see your brothers and sisters of the skies. You have been a race of beings who look at the ground beneath your feet when you walk. You look down at your watches, you search in the dirt under your feet for buried treasure. You long for riches to appear in the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow, where it touches the ground. Your spoken words are filled with downward meanings. You are down when you feel sad. You are downtrodden when you give away your own freedom. You are under the weather when you are ill, and you find yourselves in the dumps when things go against you. When life deals you a disappointment, it's all downhill. Your intemperate ways put you into a hole, and when you have more than one challenge you think you are going down the drain. Down, may I remind you, is the opposite of up. I am going to tell you why it has taken so long for you to be introduced to your brothers and sisters from the skies. It is because it has been over your heads to acknowledge that you are not the only fish in the sea, the only planet in the universe which could sustain life. You have clung so tightly to the precious idea that you are alone in the universe, the supreme intelligence of your planet, and the masters of all you possess, and you think you possess everything you behold. You go about your lives as if you created your own planet out of nothing, achieved what you have by the sheer force of your will, and no one else could have accomplished such a marvelous feat, ever. This is what you would call a syndrome, an ego problem. It makes you egotistical and myopic, although you are also charming in your self-glorifying ways, as a toddler who squeals when it manages to clap its two hands together, and when three consecutive steps brings a sense of triumph beyond words. Yes, you are adorable, as you are abominable. You love your own kind, however you define that, and you vilify and abuse others. You rape and pillage your Mother Earth even as you glorify and celebrate her beauty in photographs and paintings, as you have done with your own human females. You are a paradox, a noisy, squabbling, pushing and shoving gaggle of wondrously imaginative, emotionally sensitive and cleverly creative children, and you are so easily offended and so intolerant of children yourselves that you probably think I am insulting you. I am not. I am only trying to give you a sense of how difficult it is for us to entrust you with decisions which could affect the entire multiverse without simultaneously putting restrictions on your freedom of choices. You have blown up yourselves and your planet when your considerable creativity and intelligence allowed you to develop the technology to do so. You must admit, you love blowing things up. You are reckless, inclined toward violence in all its forms, and endlessly imaginative in your application of cruelty to one another and to other living things, for which you have no mercy. Now, that is only the darker side of humankind. You are also the most passionately loving, heroically self-sacrificing, and ferociously protective of those you love. Your capacity for loyalty and enduring emotional attachment is legendary, as is your ability to create astonishingly beautiful works of art and to be touched so deeply by music and inspiring words that you often weep with joy in their presence. Your love for your children is so intense that you fear for their deaths every moment they live, and you cling to them with such fierce passion that you risk strangling the life out of them even as you nurture their bodies and fill their minds with endless streams of trivial information. You have all but ignored your connection to me and to those who oversee your care, your guides and masters and your own higher selves. In your rush to accumulate wealth and power, by intergalactic standards you have developed the singularly obnoxious qualities of greed and selfishness, which are absolutely contrary to universal law. All in all, beloved ones, you are what one of your clever slangsters called a hot mess. And now, young gladiators, you wish to be welcomed into the exquisitely ordered and peaceful pleasures of higher dimensional life. In your gloriously blossoming hearts you long to be a part of the trust and companionship you remember from your lives at home, when you were not burdened by the troublesome three-dimensional human bodies you have worn in these earth lifetimes. Your souls yearn for the warmth and connection to your brothers and sisters of light, but your courageous experiment in earthly adaptation is still evolving. You have reached a tipping point, a watershed moment in the development of humankind. You can taste it, and it makes you nearly frantic with desire. Such is the quality of this, your most complex strain of human beingness. What you lack in self-discipline and restraint, you make up for in courage and will. You are the hearts of my heart, the dreamers of my dream, and you are your magnificent unique selves. You begin each incarnation as calm and resolute souls, then you blaze with glory or you crash and burn, but rarely do you fail to learn and grow. Now you plead your case before the councils to grant you graduation to higher levels. Your mother planet has been elevated and you wish to match her ascension, thereby gaining the privileges that go with it. I will grant you your fervent prayers, not because of their intensity alone but because they are now so generous of spirit. You pray not for yourselves but for your civilization, for peace and for abundance for your neighbors, and many of you have learned forgiveness of your enemies. It is you who will lead in the building of a new civilization when the doors of heaven open and your lovely family of beings of every shape, color and size pour forth in their enthusiasm to embrace and welcome you into the intergalactic family. First, you will be tested. The ships of the Ashtar Command will be allowed to decloak, making their presence known to every man, woman and child on the planet. The spontaneous response of the people of Gaia will determine the course of the coming era. Are you ready for that? Will you each sustain your faith and be willing to embrace, once and for all, the qualities of kindness, compassion, forgiveness, truth and unconditional love in all you do? It will now be your path to be in complete command of your every thought, feeling and action, as you begin your new golden age. You have earned the opportunity to try for the highest timeline you can reach for. I give you my blessings, and I lovingly pray for your triumph. Prime Creator. Channeled by Catherine May. www.whoneedsly.org